Hi Capricorn, Trishna here. Welcome to your September to October love tarot reading. So what I'm feeling for you Capricorn and the Capricorn collective consciousness is I feel like your romantic relationship is actually going really well, but internally Capricorn, you feel very, very stressed. The stress is coming from the fact that Capricorn, sometimes in your relationships and just in life in general, you can have certain expectations or certain rules that you expect other people to follow or to fall into. And you don't always verbalize these rules, but you still kind of have this expectation out there. And you know on some level that sometimes the rules aren't really realistic, or sometimes the rules aren't really reasonable, or you know, something like that. But in your mind, you still kind of hold to this kind of discipline or these kinds of rules and expectations. And when people don't fall into them or aren't able to live up to them, which is almost all the time, because nobody really has it as together as you do, Capricorn, so people just aren't at your level. When they don't really fall into it, it really stresses you out. And you know, like I was saying before, that, hey, maybe I'm putting unrealistic expectations on other people. You understand that, but for some reason, it can still kind of stress you out. So Capricorn, I think your relationship is going well, but I think that you're struggling a little bit with some of your own mental boxes that you put on other people, or mental rules that you put on other people, and how that stresses you out. But I think you're going to be able to work through it, Capricorn, because you understand what's going on. And when you understand that, you kind of know how to work with yourself and take it from there. So looking at the tarot cards, the first card that we have here is a death card. This card traditionally represents a transformation that's happening, or some kind of change that is slow moving. What I'm feeling for you, Capricorn, from an intuitive perspective, though, is I feel like this card is basically symbolizing that you have been through some kind of battle. You've been through some kind of battle, and you feel a little bit worn out, worn thin. And you may have had this battle or some kind of battle that you've been like fighting for love or something like that. But basically, you've had this battle, you feel really worn out, you feel kind of tired. And you see now, after you come out of this battle, that there are people, or there is something really good at the end of it. That there is a really positive outcome. There are people here to be there for you. There are people here to kind of celebrate you. And you kind of maybe know that there is like the dawn of the new day coming up. Like there is a new day. There is good that's going to be coming out of this or coming in the future. But you can't always really connect that, because you also feel like through all this battle, through all this fighting, there's been a lot that has been lost that really didn't need to be lost. And so you have a hard time, like you see, you're like tired, and then you do see that there are people there who are there to support you, or there's like some kind of celebration aspect to this, something really positive. You know that good things are to come, but you also can't separate from the damage that has been done so far. Not to worry though, Capricorn, because the next card is the Wheel of Fortune. So the Wheel of Fortune here symbolizes that, Capricorn, I think you've been doing a lot of work. I feel like you've been either doing a lot of studying, or you've been really working on yourself. And I feel like because of that, because you've really been looking at yourself and working on yourself and trying to improve yourself, and all of that work has been the result of maybe some negative things in the relationship, or some realizations that you've had or something like that. Because you've been doing all this work, I feel like the heavens are kind of shining down upon you. First of all, because you've been doing all this work, the wheels are about to turn in your favor. And second of all, I feel like the heavens are kind of shining down upon you. They recognize everything that you've been doing, how you've been trying to improve yourself, how you've been trying to make yourself better. And they really respect that, and they really honor that. And so what they're now stepping in to do is to make the path forward easier, to make things flow in your favor, and to basically turn the wheel to the Wheel of Fortune for you. So that's really a positive, Capricorn. So we kind of have two cards here that are basically saying, hey, I know you've been doing a lot of work, you've been fighting for something, but there are good things to come even though you can't see it. Hey, I know that there have been some situations that have caused you to take a deeper look at yourself, and you've done the work, and now the heavens are turning the wheel in your favor, and they're making the path significantly easier. So this may have to do with what I was picking up in the intuitive portion at the very beginning, of maybe some of these rules and expectations that you are aware of that maybe you have been working on, but it could be anything that you're working on with regards to maybe the esoteric realm and those studies, or with regards to growing as a person on a spiritual level, or with regards to your romantic relationship. The final card that we have here is the Justice card. So what I feel this represents is, I feel like the people in your life, and this feels a little less romantic. It could be romantic, but I feel like this is more like the friends and maybe family in your life. I feel like they are going to start really wanting to be fair to you, Capricorn. And they may not realize that they're acting more fairly. They may not realize that they're being different now going forward. And if they do realize, they may not know why they're being more fair. And that's okay because it's basically the reason why that's happening is because spirit, again, is getting involved because they really honor the work that you've done, or there's some kind of magic at play here that's causing these shifts in the people around you to act fairly towards you. Now, I will say that this fairness is going to last either 3 weeks or like 3 months, somewhere around there, some kind of three cycle, and then it's going to start to fade away. Don't be too worried, Capricorn, because I think you can go back to the Wheel of Fortune, work on yourself, and your path will be blessed again, and they will become even more fair and it will last even longer. Or like it'll become even more a part of them to be fair to you. And I think that it'll last maybe 6 months the second time around. When that starts to fade away, you go back to the Wheel of Fortune, you work on yourself, the spirits will bless your path, and it will become a longer term trait in others to be fair to you. I don't know if you'll have to go back to the Death card, the battle of really having to fight things out and like wear yourself out and lose things that didn't need to be lost. That may happen. You may have to go here before you go here. But just know that this is kind of a cycle and you may have to go through it a few times, but you will end up back here every time you go through the cycle. The cycle of bringing in people or kind of transforming people to help them be more fair towards you, as everybody should be, as we should all be to others. So Capricorn, that is what I'm feeling for you. I hope that this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in having a more in-depth reading with me, you can find out more information on how to do that in the description box below. And before you go, please leave me a like and a subscribe, and I will see you in my next video.